Today on BRStv, we're going to discuss two-part calcium and alkalinity solutions. In this episode, we'll cover what two-part is, a bit of information about different brands, how to dose it, as well as a few tips on long-term use. Two-part is basically a solution for dosing calcium and alkalinity to the tank using two different jugs. The calcium jug is typically filled with a solution of calcium chloride and the other sodium carbonate or bicarbonate for alkalinity. Most of them are designed to add equal amounts each day. The system can be used on basically any size tank. The only thing that changes is the size of jug you use for holding each solution. For tanks less than 150 gallons, most people will use a gallon-sized container. Tanks in the hundreds of gallons will probably use something much larger, like a 5-gallon pail. As long as there's a lid on the container to prevent evaporation, the solutions can be stored almost indefinitely. So many people will select a container as large as possible to reduce maintenance tasks. I believe two-part to be the easiest and most accurate method of maintaining calcium and alkalinity. It's also one of the most affordable as well. There isn't a tremendous amount of work or complexity to this system. More or less, all you need to do is find the right amount to dose and add that amount each day. You can automate this with a couple of dosing pumps, and the only real task becomes refilling your jug every month or so. Really doesn't get much easier than that. Kalkwasser and calcium reactors are also excellent solutions, but it can be difficult to achieve the same level of accuracy for most newer reefers. Kalkwasser is often affected by the age of the solution and frequently also dependent on or limited by the volume of a daily evaporation, which can change. These things make it difficult to make precise adjustments to the volume of calcium and alkalinity added. It is easier to adjust the amounts dosed with a calcium reactor by adjusting the drip rate of the solution added to the tank or the potency of the solution by adjusting the amount of CO2. While this does make it easy to adjust, it takes a bit of practice to properly tune a calcium reactor so the bubble rate and drip rate result in the output of calcium and alkalinity that matches your tank's daily consumption, a process that needs to be repeated as corals grow and consume more elements. The reason we feel two-part is the most accurate option is each jug contains a known amount of calcium and alkalinity. So the results of adding more or less solution is fairly predictable. There are even calculators available to tell you exactly how much you need to add to make the changes you're looking for. Adjusting for growth is as simple as increasing your daily dose. There are a whole slew of retail two-part brands available these days. Biggest differences between all of them is if they come in a liquid or dry form, how they deal with trace elements, and whether or not they're a true two-part or do they actually have three parts. The liquid forms are the easiest to use because most of them come pre-mixed. However, they're also often the most expensive as well. I think this makes them appropriate for smaller tanks or for people who don't mind paying for convenience. There are also some brands which offer dry versions like the Fauna Marine or Red Sea. These are often considerably more affordable but require you to mix it with purified water. Since this is super easy, I think most people are probably better served with the dry versions. Each brand handles trace elements differently as well. There are a few brands that mix it in directly with the two-part and some of them that make it available as separate solutions. There's an obvious ease of use benefit with combining them with the two-part. However, offering trace elements in separate solutions allows them to include additional elements that can't be combined in high concentrations with calcium or alkalinity solutions. This is the same reason some brands come in three parts, where the third part is typically magnesium. The true two parts are mixing the magnesium and calcium solutions together, which makes it easier because there are only two products to dose. However, the three parts typically contain major elements in ratios which match natural seawater more closely. In most cases, three parts are also better options for making large adjustments to a single element. For instance, if I want to raise my calcium from 380 to 420, I don't necessarily want to raise magnesium or a variety of trace elements at the same time. Last but not least, we have our bulk package version of two-part. This is easily the most affordable retail version available. I also believe it's the highest grade of material available to the aquarium industry. We use only pharmaceutical grade calcium and magnesium materials. The difference between the grades of material is dramatic enough to be seen visually. The pharmaceutical grade material dissolves crystal clear. These other two are a couple of the more popular retail brands of calcium chloride aquarium additives. You can see there's a significant amount of residue that settles out of the bottom, and that's just the impurities you can see with the naked eye. Our two-part kit comes with a container of calcium chloride, sodium carbonate, as well as magnesium chloride and sulfate. We include a couple of measuring cups, some jugs, and dispensing pumps. There's also a version that includes a pair of dosing pumps to automate the system. Regardless of the brand you use, two-part typically involves the following. First, we need to get the levels up to where you want them. We typically suggest a calcium level of 420 parts per million, a DKH of 9, and magnesium at 1350 parts per million. Some people prefer a slightly lower alkalinity of 7 to 8, which is closer to natural sea levels. I've seen tanks thrive anywhere in this range. If you're using BRS two-part, raising the levels is super easy. We have an easy-to-use reef calculator in our site where you can enter your tank size, what your current levels are, your desired level, and what you're using to raise them. For example, if we had a 100-gallon tank with a calcium level of 380 and we wanted to get to 420 using two-part calcium mix, it would tell us we need 409 milliliters to do so. Once added to the tank, you should be able to come back to the tank and test minutes later. Now that we have the levels up, it's time to figure out how much to use to maintain these new levels. I would check the manufacturer's dosing suggestions and start with that, but it'll probably need to be adjusted. Adjusting is fairly easy. Use your test kits to find out which directions the levels are going. If they're going down, increase your daily dose. If they're going up, adjust it down. It shouldn't take more than a few adjustments to hone in on the right dose where the levels are stable. Once you find it, you should only need to tweak them every few months as you add additional corals or to keep up with growth. The doses should be added slowly to a high flow area of the tank, and it's normal for the alkalinity to cloud the water temporarily. It should dissipate fairly quickly. The doses can be done manually, but it's best to use a cheap dripper to add the dose over a couple of hours if possible. If you automate it with a couple of dosers like these, which dose 1.1 milliliter per minute, it's pretty easy to not only spread the dose over a long period of time, but you can also dose each solution at different times, which is ideal. There's some really cool dosers out there like the Vertex Libra that has intelligent programming, which makes setting up and changing your dosing schedule ridiculously easy using a touchpad screen. The process is so intuitive, I think basically anyone can figure it out in less than a minute. Time for a few quick two-part tips. You can use pretty much any reef-safe container to store your two-part. There are some really cool vessels from various manufacturers which add some style to the sump area and match other equipment. You can make your own using a Murlock bulkhead in virtually any container. Most of them have a neat down tube which draws about an inch off the bottom to prevent dosing any precipitate. This isn't required for BRS two-part because ours dissolves completely, but it looks nice regardless. Next, it can be difficult to dissolve the alkalinity component of any brand's two-part. If it clumps up on you, we suggest floating the jug in a sink of hot water to raise the temperature and make it easier to dissolve. The best way is to mix it in an open-top container where it's easy to stir and add the powder at the same time. If you take this step, it dissolves almost instantly without clumping issues. Lastly, one thing you want to consider when using two-part over a long period of time is the eventual buildup of chloride and sodium ions from the calcium chloride and sodium carbonate. This effect is very minimal as long as you have a reasonable water chain schedule. If you see your salinity rising, this is probably one of the reasons. For this and a whole variety of other reasons, we suggest stringing together a few larger water changes once a year to get a high volume of new water into the tank and reduce or remove any contaminants or trace and macro elements that may have built up over the year. This advice really applies to any tank regardless of the calcium solution used. That wraps up today's episode. This week's question of the week is, which brand and how much two-part do you dose every day? Next week, we'll be covering calcium reactors. If you'd like to be notified when this episode comes out, hit that subscribe button. Thank you for watching BRStv.